Hi, everyone. I'm Yev.
And I'm James.
We're here with another episode of Stocks and Storage. And today we're going to be talking about market cap. What is it? The only caps I'm really familiar with are ball caps and night caps, but market cap seems to come up quite a bit as one of the things that's on like a Yahoo Finance page. When I go there, I see a ton of numbers. One of them is market cap. Seems to change all the time. Why is that?
Yeah, so when a company goes public, like Backblaze did back in November of last year, they divide the company into a bunch of shares. You know, every company has a different number of what they call shares outstanding. How many pieces of the company can you buy? And so when they become listed, you get a daily view of the value of the company, because that stock price multiplied times the number of shares outstanding, that's what's called your market capitalization. Your capitalization, again, just capital is money. So it's basically, what is the market telling you is the value of the shares in the company?
So when people say that it's a $1 billion company or it's a $10 billion company, what are they talking about? Is that like a revenue thing, or is it referring to the market cap?
Well, honestly, you know, people kind of pick and choose what numbers, you know, they're going to talk about. And I think there's kind of like roughly three that people, when they say a company is a $1 billion company, you know, for example, they often mean, okay, well, they have a $1 billion in revenue on an annual basis is one way. In many cases, they're talking about market capitalization. The company's stock is worth $1 billion. That's an easy number to get. There's also a third one. This is a little more for the advanced topic, but you know, enterprise value is another one. So basically, all that is the market capitalization adjusted for the amount of debt and cash the company has. But that's a topic for another episode, perhaps, and a little bit dry. But you know, those are generally the three metrics that people are talking about when they're talking about the, you know, the size of a company.
Got it. And so sometimes important to double check exactly what they mean if they're throwing numbers around like that.
Check the fine print.
Check the fine print. That's a good investment advice, actually. Thank you. I think that's a great breakdown. And when we went public, one of the reasons for doing that, I think, and why these numbers are important, right, is so that people know what they're investing in, right? So when Backblaze went public, kind of having that information be out there, we have to do the quarterly earnings, the filings, all that stuff, like that gives additional context to all those numbers that you see on the screen, right?
That's right, yeah. I think you're ready for a nightcap.
Yeah, perfect. All right. Well, thank you, James, and we'll see everyone on the next episode of Stocks and Storage. Go like this.
Bean cam rolling.
That one.
A little bit lower?
Yes.